Hey guys, what's up? I am Nikhil from Dope Motions and welcome to this brand new After Effects tutorial. In today's video, I'm going to show you guys how to create this dynamic text animation inside of After Effects without using any third-party plugin. But before we start today's video, make sure to follow me on Instagram at dope.motions. All the links are in the description below. With that said, now let's jump into After Effects and get started. Alright guys, so here we are in After Effects. Let's start by creating a new composition. Let's call this render as our main render comp. 1920 by 1080, 30 fps and 10 seconds long duration. Press OK. Now let's create another new comp. This is going to be our logo placeholder. So let's call this logo and press OK. You can of course use any logo that you want to, but I'm going to use a text. So actually we should call it a text placeholder, but it's fine. Let's type in our text. So I'm going to type in grind, just like you saw in the example. And for the font, I'm using the Game of Squid font. I will mention the link to this font in the description below, so you can go ahead and download it. So I'm going to make this a bit bigger, like so. Align this into the center. Now let's create another new composition. We will be creating a lot of different compositions for this particular tutorial because it's a bit advanced tutorial. We have to cover a lot of different techniques, create a lot of different things to achieve the final look. So let's just bear with me. I'm going to type in line underscore 01. Press OK. And this is the composition where we will create those saber-like things, but we don't want to use any kind of a plugin. So we will be using a built-in effect that is called Vegas. So let's drag the logo composition inside the line comp. Go to effects and presets, search for Vegas effect. All right, let's set the blend mode to transparent so we can see what's going on. And also I'll change the color to white. Let's bring down the segments to 1. All right, bring down the width to 1.5. Also bring down the start opacity to 0 and bring up the end opacity to 1. Now we can go ahead and animate the rotation and the length of the segments. So I'll move my time indicator at the very start, create a keyframe on the length and the rotation. Let's bring down the length to 0 and press U so we can see the keyframes. I'll go to 1 second and 10 frames somewhere around here and let's set the length to 1. Then go to 3 seconds and let's give it a rotation of around 200 should be fine. Also, I will animate the opacity. So I'll create a keyframe on the opacity. Press T to bring down the opacity property. Let's drag this keyframe to around 2 seconds and let's set this to 0. So if I press U, we can see all the keyframes. So here we have our animation looking pretty nice. We can select all the keyframes. Press F9 to easy ease them or just go into keyframe assistant, easy ease. All right, so that is looking fine. Let's also add a simple choker effect on this of around -3. So we have the strokes a little bit more intensified, maybe -2, -3 is a bit too much. Yep, that is looking much better. Now let's go back into our main project panel, duplicate this. So now we have line 2, double click to open this up. And let's add a different color. I'm gonna go with a nice blue one. All right. And let's go at 3 seconds and change the rotation to 1. Give it a 1 complete rotation. So we have a little bit variation between the line 1 and the line 2. Now let's create another new composition called this edge. Press OK. We can press Ctrl K to bring up the composition settings and change the background color to white so we can see what's going on here. Drag the logo composition. Let's go into effects and presets and search for an effect called fine edges. Double click to apply that. And then I will also add a tint just to make sure it's a black and white edge. Now the reason that we are creating this edge, I will tell you as we proceed with this tutorial. Now I want to create a refraction map in order to build that reflection layer onto our text. So to do that, I'll create a new composition called this map. Press OK. Press Ctrl K again actually and bring down the background color to black. Press Ctrl Y to create a new solid. Call this BG for background and make sure it's black. Press OK. And I'll select the pen tool. Make sure the stroke is set to 0 and I'll set the fill to something like a nice gray color, like so. And I'm going to create some really random shapes. Something like this. And let's create one more. So something like this. Okay, so now we have some really random shapes. And on top of this, I'll create some white shapes. And this doesn't need to be very precise. As you can see, I'm doing this very randomly. Just make sure they don't have any hard edges. So that is fine. Now let's create another new composition, call this refraction, and add the map that we just created. Let's go ahead and actually animate this. I'm gonna make it something like that. Go right here, select it, press P to bring down the position, create a keyframe, go to around 5 seconds, and let's drag this like so. Now we have a simple movement like this. Let's create a new adjustment layer, call this a displace. Go into effects and presets, search for turbulent displace, apply that. Let's set this to around 75 and this to 300. So now as we proceed further, we have this nice wavy look. Now I know it looks quite weird at the moment, but as we go ahead with this tutorial, you will get the idea of what we are doing here. Now actually we will start building our refraction for the text, basically creating those glossy reflection onto our text. So I'll create a new composition, call this refraction build, press OK. I'll press Control K, I can actually set the background color to white so we can see what's going on. Now let's drag the edge composition, hide that. Then on top of that, I will add the refraction composition. And on top, I will add the logo composition. Select the refraction composition. And you can see we have something like this. So select it, go into effects and presets, search for an effect called CC glass, double click to apply that, go in the surface and set this to edge, and then toggle switch, set the blend mode of the refraction to screen, and change the blend mode of the logo to stencil alpha. Now we have something like this, but it doesn't look quite like a refraction. So let's go back into our refraction, increase the softness of the CC glass to 90 and set this one to 100 and bring down the displacement to minus 500. Then go into the light, set this to 90 and increase the light height to 100. Now let's add another effect called CC blobbilize. Go into the blobbiness, set this to edge, set the cutaway to 20 and let's go into the light, bring that down to 75 and bring that up to 75. So now you can see we have a much more refractive text, which is looking quite nice. I think looking pretty good. Yep. Now let's add some depth into our refraction. So to build this, I'm going to create a new composition called this refraction 3D depth and let's make it black. Press OK. Drag the refraction build layer. Turn this into a 3D layer and press P to bring down the position. Now we need to separate the dimensions. So we have X, Y, and Z. Let's right click and click on separate dimensions. And we will add a very simple expression on the Z position, because what we want to do is every time I duplicate it, I want that particular composition to move one frame, sorry, not one frame, but one point behind as I keep on duplicating. So let's hold Alt and click on the stopwatch, type in index. That's all. Now, as you can see, the Z position is set to a value of 1. If I duplicate this, now it's at 2 and this one is at 1. So we have to create around, I think 30 copies should be fine. So I'm going to press Control D until we have 30 copies. We have 27 and 3 more. All right. So this has created a nice 3D depth into the scene. Now I know it's a bit difficult to visualize right now, but if I create just a camera for now, so let's, what we can do is actually select them all and turn on the shy layer. Let's right click and create a camera, maybe 50 millimeters. And press C to switch into the camera tool. And if I rotate it, you can see we have a nice 3D depth. Looks pretty cool. We can also actually select the top layer, go into effects and presets, search for exposure, and let's increase the intensity of this just so that we can separate it. As you can see, looking pretty nice. So let's delete the camera. This was just for the visualization. So now we have our 3D scene ready. Now let's create another new composition and let's just call this 3D. And now we have to do something similar for the stroke, but but we cannot use the same index technique here. So we will do this manually. So what we have to do is select the line two, drag and drop it right here. So we have this, turn this into a 3D layer. Now we will create 15 copies of this particular composition. So press Ctrl D until we have 15 copies. Yep, there you go. And then select them all, press P to bring down the position, and let's change the Z position of these. So let's set this one to 8, this one to 12, this one to 16, 20, or separate them by value of 4. So 16, 20, 24, and so on. And there you go. Now we have created a nice 3D dimension with the lines as well. If I right click again, create a new camera, you can see we have this. And that is the look that I want to go for. Pretty cool. Delete the camera. Now select the top layer and go into effects and presets, search for fill effect. Double click to apply that, and I'm going to make this white. Okay. And let's also add some nice glow to this. Let's set the radius to 30. So now we have this really nice animation, as you can see. And now finally, we can start building up the final render scene. It's like building up all the puzzle, connecting all the dots. So let's start by creating a background. Press Ctrl Y to create a new solid. Call this BG for background. Then I'll add the logo composition. Then we'll add the refraction 3D depth composition. Make sure you turn on the collapse transformation and the 3D layer. Make sure you turn it into a 3D layer. So now we have something like this, which is looking pretty nice. Now let's add the line one composition on top. Turn this into a 3D layer. Press P to bring down the position and set the Z space of this to -5. Go to effects and presets and search for fill effect. Double click to apply that, and let's add a similar blue color. And then I will add a fast box blur on this. All right, let's duplicate this maybe 5 or 6 times. I think 5 times should be fine. Press P so we can see the position. Let's make this one more copy. Set the position of this one to -10, this one to -15, -20, -25, and -30. Select the second one and change the fast box blur value to 10. Select the third one, set this to 20, fourth one to 30, and fifth one to 40. And I guess this one will be 50. So now we have a nice glow around our text, which is looking quite nice. As you can see, looking pretty cool. Now let's go back into our main project panel. We can actually hide this and add the 3D composition on top. Turn this into a 3D layer and also turn on collapse transformation. Press B to bring down the position and let's set this to -60. So now we have everything on top. Now let's right click and create a new adjustment layer. Let's call this glow. Go to effects and presets, search for a glow effect. Double click to apply that, and also make sure you're working in 16 bits per channel. So hold Alt and click on this. This is very important. And then let's go back into our glow, set this to 50 and 50, and bring down the glow intensity to 0.5. Then duplicate this, set this to 1000. So now we have this really nice glow. Maybe we can bring down the intensity to 0.4 or something. Now right click and create a new adjustment layer. This is again going to be a second glow. Double click to apply the glow. Set the threshold to 20 and let's increase the radius to 1000. So now we have a very intense glow, and maybe I can bring that down to 0.6 or something. Yep, that looks much better. Or maybe 0.8 should be fine, because we can add a nice curves adjustment. So let's create another adjustment layer, call this CC for color correction, and then I'm going to search for curves effect. Double click to apply that. Let's increase the contrast a little bit like that. Go into the blue channel and increase the blue value a little bit more. Okay, now on top of this, I will add the logo composition. Let's move this to around 1 second and 15 frames, and I'm going to add a linear wipe effect on this. Set the transition completion to 100% and set this one to -90 and the feather to 500. Let's create a keyframe on the transition completion. Go to 5 seconds and set this to 0. So now we have something like this. Okay, now let's go ahead and add the refraction build layer on top. Change the blend mode of this to add. Turn both the layers into 3D, and now we can add a nice camera movement. So now right click and create a new camera. make sure to select the 50 millimeter preset and then right click and create a new null object. This is going to be our cam controller. So let's call this cam control and make sure it's 3D and link the camera to this null object. Select the camera, press P to bring down the position. Let's go to 1 second. Set the Y position to 2000 and the Z position to -1000. Create a keyframe, go to 4 second. Set the Y position to 0 and this one to -3000. So now we have something like this. Let's go ahead and add some nice rotation as well. So to do that, I'll use the cam controller that we just created. So press R to bring down the rotation properties and I will only animate the Z rotation. So let's create a keyframe at the very start, set this to 270 and then I'll go to 3 seconds and set this to 0. So now when we preview this, we have this really nice movement, as you can see, pretty cool. Let's select the keyframes. We can press F9 to easy ease them or go into keyframe assistant, easy ease, go into the graph editor, right click and select edit speed graph, select this point and let's drag them like so. So now when we preview this, we have something like this. I think we will animate the position in a different way. So I'll select the position only and let's tweak the graph a little bit. So now we have a nice movement, looks pretty nice. Yeah, that is exactly what I want to go for. And as some final touches, we can add some noise actually, just so that we don't get any kind of color bendings. Go into effects and presets, search for noise and double click, unlink this, set this to 5%. And let's set everything to full and preview our final animation. And there we have a cinematic text animation inside of After Effects without using any plugin. If you enjoy this video, make sure to check out my complete playlist dedicated to creating title animations, text animations, and logo reveals. All the links are in the description below. You can also support me on Patreon. So with that said, I will see you guys in the next video. Till then, take care and always stay raw, stay creative. Peace out.